the good times, moonlight raising from the grave, string band playing more, that honky tonk's pretty young thing going dancing in the rain. Lady spitting at the Nicky Jacks, businessman with a needle and a spoon, coyote chewing on a cigarette, pack of young boys going howling at the moon. Hey darling, sleeping on the blacktop, hey darling, running through the trees, honey, hey darling, leaving for the next town, letting my sense catches up with me.
Good to see
you. Oh, sure.
Morning.
Good morning. Well, we rolled in late last night. A little bit of a late start, but we getting a little game plan together as far as where we want to go this morning. To start off, we got so much area back here to cover. It's going to be just kind of bomb around and see what it looks like. Got a lot of X's on the map, but we'll definitely go in a handful of miles to start with the ability to go in a whole lot more. So I think get these bags packed up, eat a little bit of food, and bomb up the mountain.
Been an elk every day this season except for last night. So the pressure's on.
So we just got to get into elk today.
Yeah.
Do we want to kill one today though? Really? A lot of food in the pack.
Too much food, yeah.
Too much
food. The pack needs to get lighter before we put more weight in it.
We have elk, two elk tags, so yeah, we do. It's getting up there. It's getting some elevation for sure. Old burn. It's kind of on a rock face, but there is a big pond there.
Yeah.
All right. Well, shall we? We got our spot picked out, and let's go find some bulls. Hopefully, get something to play this afternoon.
Just go that way. Yeah, we do.
We gotta split here before we hook into that burn.
Okay.
I looked up there and it was like a big yellow body.
He stood there.
Good bull.
Yeah. Back a good six.
Maybe go play with this guy, see if we can get him in. What you do is go light. Dump some stuff here until that's 1,054 yards. Line distance from where we are. You can pinpoint exactly where he's at. It's really easy to like put a dot right where he is. So when we go bailing up there, we'll know exactly where we need to come out. This is like the solo hunter's dream. Dad knows.
because you never have a spotter or anything. You just know exactly where he's at. So we got a bull. We spotted a bull up here. And first bull, first morning. So we're going to go check out and play with him a little bit, see what we can do. Practice. It's a practice round. So we're going to cut over here, get up on this bench, stay a little bit below him. Wind is kind of directional like this, so go hit him with a couple cow calls, see if he fires up. If he doesn't, we'll try to get in tight. I saw him look like he was going to be bedded right on the top. And we'll try to get in tight and pick a fight if the cow calling doesn't work. But it'd be nice to call him down to us.
Yeah.
That'd be great.
Let's do that.
Yeah, we shoot him when he runs down this way. It'd be even better.
The butter bags.
Thank you.
James. He's like, he's coming in.
We saw a bull just over here. We came up, hiked up, tried to find him. We ended up getting a squeal over here on this little bench, and we just called him in. Jaden called him in, and what did we have him, 25 yards? Maybe? Somewhere like that. But,
marked that one up for Phelps.
That was a paint call. No, he came right in. He was licking his lips.
Straight across. is a 5 or 6. But it's got 9 or 8 cows.
Elks among us.
There are elks.
That ridge does look good though. Yeah. It's like a flat ridge. And then it's pretty.
It's similar to what we got going on above us.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I think we'll probably go back down. Pitch them up down there. Push this back up and over tomorrow, eh? Mm-hmm. I think we got cruise through this early in the dark. We'll probably hear some stuff. I like that up there. There's so much nice timber.
Oh, there's so many pockets.
Yeah, I think they'll be out. We'll probably get some good glassing in the morning, but. And again, we can also just bomb around at night, camp there, just come up here and see if we hear them.
I bet you, I mean, you can hear from the top of this, you can hear that.
Yeah. Yeah, this country's pretty cool. So much glassing, I had no idea it was gonna be this open. I mean, that mountain over there is huge. That's where the Critter Creeks are.
Critter Creeks.
They go up into that. Not what I expected. But looks pretty good.
I would imagine all this just burnt off like 20 years ago or something before they kept record.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of the 03 burns, but a lot of this was probably way before that.
Did they make it? A lot farther.
No way in that cave, I might be able to beat you. You're taller.
Yeah.
I'm taller than you.
So, today, man, I don't know, we had a pretty good day, I think, for our hike in. Got up here, dropped our packs, went for a bull that we had seen just for a few seconds up on this ridge, and ended up going up there to try to find him. We didn't find him, but we did call in a 4-point, which was kind of cool. It was a fun little thing to play with. And then we never did find that big one, but we did see kind of end of the day, a pretty nice herd. James picked it up. Far ridge had like 8 cows with it, so I think tomorrow we're just gonna get up in the dark and start hiking, pack up, try to put on some miles and see if we can hear anything bugling. And if we do, we're going for it. But pretty good country. We haven't seen a soul up here, so I think we got a pretty good shot at finding a big old bull, hopefully. What do you think, Jaden?
We're going to call in each of us an elk tomorrow.
Each of us an elk.
Yeah.
Yeah, this would be a great pack out. Not too bad. Oh, how many miles are we in here? 5?
Right about 5.
5? Yeah, that'd be nice. All downhill.